the main reason why I chose Southern Miss was I was offered an athletic scholarship. And I knew a lot of people that were down there playing football at the time from up in this area. And also the fact that my the coach recruiting me, Coach Lee Floyd, he was a big influence in me going there. And, you know, he made a great impression on me.
Well, I was born and raised and lived most of my life in South Mississippi. And I graduated from a two-year college, Kapaa Lincoln Junior College at that time. And I had a friend in high school who came here and got a degree in psychology. And on weekends, he would come back and he'd tell me about his experiences in that. And then in the two-year college, I was interested in the sciences and math. And one of my best friends then and now in life, he and I were taking calculus together and biology together. We were study partners. So when we graduated, we said, where do we go? The answer was University of Southern Mississippi. And it was only 118 miles from my front door to this front door. And so it was convenient and a quality institution.
The reason I chose Southern Miss is because my dad was on faculty at Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College, and so it was a no-brainer actually that we were going to start at a community college regardless of any freshman opportunities at the university, scholarships or whatever. He felt like we all needed to get that grounding at a community college, his community college. And so the real question was, where do you go after Gulf Coast Community College? And I have a sister and several brothers. I'm the youngest of eight. And many of us have made the trek to USM. We all have a little bit of black and gold in our blood.
To tell you the truth, it was a family legacy. I've had aunts and uncles and cousins that had attended the university, and back then it was Mississippi College, to tell you the truth. So when I came out of high school in 1975, I had an opportunity to play athletics at several schools, but University of Southern Miss had offered me a scholarship where I could play football and baseball, and they had a degree program that I was most interested in, so it was just a natural thing for me.
My situation was a little different. I grew up in Poplarville, Mississippi, and went to Poplarville High School, and then on to we had a local junior college, community college is known today, but Pearl River Junior College at the time. And I wanted to go into accounting and had been exposed to it at Pearl River Junior College. And so, you know, looking for where the best college for accountant majors were, Southern had a great reputation as in a business school in their accounting department. So I thought, you know, that was a easy choice for me. It was close to home. I had a good education.
Mississippi Southern College was highly recommended by my teachers in high school at Macomb and Summit, Mississippi. Also, I had friends that had attended Southern Miss, and the location was of importance to me.
My most fondest memory of being a student at USM was when my daughter was born in Hattiesburg, at Hattiesburg General Hospital. And also the fact that I scored 1,000 points in my career at Southern Miss. And being inducted into the Sports Hall of Fame for both basketball and baseball.
The activities I was involved in were academic. I came to this university for one reason and one reason alone. I'm a first generation graduate, and I came here to get a degree. And so my interest at this university was in doing well in the subject area. My most fond memory was graduation. And the reason it was graduation, my parents had never been to this institution, drove over from Franklin County, Mississippi to Hattiesburg on a Saturday afternoon. And it just as it is today, we walked around campus and I showed them the buildings, the labs, and the areas where I had lived.
You know, I have 3 degrees from the University of Southern Miss, and so I have fond memories from each stage of my educational career. But you know, the faculty at USM, in particular, Dr. Art Sutherland, he was our department chair in the Ed Psych building. Dr. Sutherland was just such a caring individual, and he made it his mission to make sure that not only I succeeded, but all the individuals in our PhD program. And so he, like many instructors that I had at the University of Southern Miss, were so focused on student success and so focused on making us feel like we were a part of the university. So I always felt like I made a good choice, and those memories are there because I always felt like I belonged.
My most fond memory is probably the people. You know, it's an exciting time at the university. In athletics, we just finished a football stadium my freshman year. So my freshman year, we didn't even play on campus. We played some games in Biloxi, but we were mostly on the road. So to come back to the university my sophomore year and play football at a brand new stadium, The Rock, and all the tradition that we take for granted today really started then. So there was an excitement at the university that I think laid the foundation, not only in athletics, but laid the foundation for the school itself to kind of move to the next level. Here at the University of Southern Miss, at least when I was here, you really knew people, and they became family and brothers. And you know, we competed tremendously on athletic fields, but those relationships have lasted all these 40 some odd years, so I'm thankful for that.
I used to go to the ball games quite often, and we would attend and just, you know, really enjoyed it. I mean, it was particularly during the Bobby Collins era. He brought a fresh new perspective from Coach Underwood, and certainly moved on from the school athletic program. Excelled during that 7 or 8 years that he was there. And I can remember, and it was against Alabama. And it was actually the last loss that Bear Bryant had in Tuscaloosa. And it was the first loss he'd had in 57 games. So we had a lot to cheer about, and it was a lot of fun. And Reggie Collier was quarterback, and the guy had legs from his armpit down to the floor. I mean, he could run, and he was exciting. And so it was a great time to be at Southern during those years.
There are many fond memories, but meeting my future wife in an accounting class was the fondest of my memories. I was involved as a Kappa Sigma in a lot of their activities, which included some competitions between fraternities. Also, I had part-time jobs, so I was busy. As a freshman, my head was shaved on the first day that I moved into The Rock, which was the old original dormitory, by the sophomores. And this was a tradition in the 1940s. They gave us a little baseball type of cap to put on our heads, and we with an S on it, and we were required to wear it.
Well, I've been a member of the Alumni Association since I graduated in 1971, which is 47 years.
Many ways. I think most significantly, having returned here as a professor and as an administrator, I had the opportunity to to represent the university in many ways. Several years ago, some of my former students and some of my colleagues decided it was important that we support the institution politically. And we formed a political action committee called Eagle PAC. And I was honored to be selected as the chair of that PAC. And our efforts were to influence our legislative and stakeholders in this state to support this institution that so it richly deserves.
Well, Dr. Bennett and I have established a wonderful relationship. So as an alum, he and I have worked together very closely to ensure that Gulf Coast Community College and University of Southern Miss, we have a parallel goal for our students. We want them to know more than just the fact that they're near us, that it's a great university with great quality instruction and great teachers who know their discipline well.
Well, ever since I left, I mean, I was stationed in Europe almost 4 years, and we always, you know, joined or were members of the alumni club, rather remote, but still back then, you know, you could get the magazine, so we always enjoyed reading about what was going on. It's been a part of our life. Like I said, USM is part of the family. It's our institution, not in a possessive sense, but we identify with its values, we identify with the type of people that that attend this university. So it's kind of like family to us.
Well, I think, certainly I have a lot of, I've supported the alumni over the years, and I'd have to say that I've had some good friends that have been heavily involved in the Alumni Association, because I've been gone for quite some time, but good friends that were mentors of mine or certainly encouraged me in my career and what I did and in my life, really. But people like Moran Pope, who really was instrumental with the Alumni Association, Powell Ogletree, there, you know, was a staunch worker and advocate of the alumni. I've been gone for 20 plus years now. And so in that time, you know, it's kind of, you just don't get back to Hattiesburg as much. And certainly I continue and will continue to support the Alumni Association.
It was an honor and a pleasure to serve Southern Miss over a period of years as a member of the advisory councils for the colleges of business, health, athletics, faculty member for our Natchez branch, and guest lecturer for graduate students in the College of Business Administration. As president of the USM Foundation, I participated in convocation ceremonies and presented awards.
It means a lot to me, you know. It's like once in a lifetime thing to be in. Whenever someone's inducted into their College Hall of Fame, alumni, sports, whatever it may be, it's a tremendous honor just to be in there with, you know, other outstanding people.
First and foremost, it's an honor, and as all of us, I'm sure we're all humbled and honored by the fact. But I think there's a symbolic part of it that's very important. I think each one of us in this class and all the other classes of Hall of Famers, we're just symbolic of all the thousands of individuals who interface and come in contact and engage this university.
Well, to be inducted into the Hall of Fame at the University of Southern Miss is just, it was an amazing phone call. I was in the process of calling our Hall of Famers at Gulf Coast Community College when the call came in. So to be on the other end of the line and receive the call was an amazing experience. And so it was a little surreal for me.
Well, I'm not sure how deserving, but certainly much appreciated. So I think of all those wonderful times and those people that you know, I'm convinced that, you're, as an individual, we're bits and pieces of all the folks and institutions that have shaped us, particularly my wife, Rosie, who has really been the rock, not only the spiritual foundation for our family, but you can imagine 32 years of military service and being gone for extended periods of time, moving around all over the world, living in different places. So she's been tremendous, and I'm grateful for her. I know I wouldn't be here now. And my kids, John and Zach, and their wives, Kelsey and Hunter, and our grandchildren, it's just a great amount of gratitude.
Well, quite frankly, it was probably one of my greatest surprises. I mean, you know, when you think about, you know, being inducted into anything, you think, what kind of contribution did you make to get into that? But I think more than anything else is what the contribution that the university made for me, that allowed me to succeed in a world of business that has taken me to several hospitals, and I've had the good fortune and been blessed to be the CEO of this institution for going on 2 years.
My immediate thought was, what an honor and a privilege. A telephone call from Jerry DeFatta took me by total surprise. When recovered from shock, I reflected on the educational foundation which I received because of the leadership skills, the management expertise and knowledge shared by the presidents, associates, and faculty during my years at USM.
Southern Miss to the top.
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 Southern Miss to the top.